836, Big 550, KTRS. Kat Neville, normally in studio. However, she's having some issues this morning. We'll get to her in a second. Jimmy's on the Park sponsors Kat Neville. Call them at 725-8585 or the website at jimmyscafe.com. Click on the Living Social link or go to livingsocial.com and get $40 worth of food for only $20 now through October 15th. For Jimmy's on the Park, do it before they're sold out. Jimmy's on the Park on the website, jimmyscafe.com. Good morning, Kat Neville.
Good morning.
What happened to your car?
Well, so I have a car that has a lot of computerized stuff, and this morning when I got in, it told me that the immobilizer was on.
Oh, boy.
What's that mean?
Watch out for the immobilizer.
Yeah, it means that it can't recognize that my electronic key is near, and so it thinks that somebody's trying to steal the car, so it has to be towed and fixed. So,
yep.
Sorry I'm not there with you this morning.
Watch out for that immobilizer.
Yes.
All right. One of the things you're talking about today is a restaurant in my hometown, which I've actually been there numerous times, Plank Road Pizza. Tell us all about it.
Yes. So I actually zipped out there, and I know that you were like, when you come out, make sure you call me. But I came out, I think it was maybe last week or the week before, and there was a deluge. The weather was crazy.
Well, and the other problem was that my immobilizer wasn't working that day.
Well, I just thought Plank Road Pizza it's adorable.
Right.
And the food is great. It's actually inside of one of the oldest buildings, one of the oldest homes in Cottleville. And they've done a really nice job of keeping a lot of the original architectural elements. But, for example, they removed the ceiling in the dining room, and so you can see all of the interior, the beams in the roof line. It's really charming. And the reason why, in case you're curious, the reason why it's named Plank Road Pizza is that back in the day, before there were paved roads, they had a plank road running through Cottleville. And it went right in front of the former house and now wonderful pizza joint, Plank Road Pizza. And the address is 5212 Highway N, and it is right in the middle, as you know, McGraw, right in the middle of the most charming historic section of Cottleville. And they have a great patio in front, and it's tiny. I mean, it seats maybe 20 people inside, and the staff is super friendly.
It is, and the pizza's good, and it's great because it's individual sized pizzas. Mm-hmm. So you go and you order your own individual pizza.
I like that individual.
Yeah.
And the pizzas are really creative. They do have some salads on the menu. Their house salad is like a St. Louis style with Provel and kind of a sweeter dressing. They have like an apple salad and a club salad, but obviously the specialty is the pizza, and they do have some local beer, and they do have wine available, but their Plank Road Pizza is a chicken bacon club, and I really love pizzas that have, like, some raw elements on top, and so they actually sprinkle on top of this pizza with, like, smoked bacon and roasted chicken, some red onion and melted mozz. Then they sprinkle on like raw romaine lettuce and some sliced avocado. And I love that play of like the hot and the cheesy and then the cold elements. It's really delicious. They have like a meatball pizza that's called the Boone's Lick. They have a buffalo chicken pizza called the St. Charles Street. And they have, you know, regular stuff like where they have, you know, just a you can just get regular pepperoni pizza if that's what you want. But it's really fun to see some of the more, you know, creative stuff, like a barbecued chicken pizza and, you know, big meat pizzas, all that kind of stuff. It's terrific.
I also think they grow their own herbs because I asked for oregano, and they brought me, like, fresh oregano straight from the garden.
Yeah, they do, and they really pride themselves on using locally sourced ingredients when possible, which is one of the reasons why they do stock a lot of the local beers in a kind of a rotating selection. And, you know, and right now we're at the height of produce season, and it's fun to see just a very approachable food like pizza kind of really focusing on using those local super high quality ingredients. And the crust is nice and tender, and it's not thin, but it's definitely not as thick. It's like a hand-formed crust,
right.
And it has a nice chew to it, and it kind of bubbles up on the edges. It's really tasty.
You know, and you mentioned a charming part of Cottleville, and since I'm a Cottleville-ian now.
Is that what it's called?
Cottleville-ian.
You got to give it to them. I mean, they got Menino's across the street. They got the wine bar right next door. They've got that martini bar behind the wine bar. They got BMO's down there. I mean, that is a great stretch right there.
It really is, and I think that there are just some absolute gems in Cottleville. You've got Van Buskirk's, that right. awesome chocolate place.
Right.
You obviously have Stone Soup Cottage, one of the best restaurants in the entire St. Louis area.
Right.
And, you know, it's just kind of this little enclave. It kind of reminds me a little bit of the way that Edwardsville has just this really great handful of fantastic restaurants. And as you know, having these unique, local places to go and patronize are what make, a town feel like a town.
Right.
I mean, who's that interested, quite frankly, in just zipping over to your neighborhood Applebee's for something? I mean, you want to feel a connection to place, and these types of local institutions are what make, would distinguish one place that you're living from another place that your friend lives.
Yeah.
It's like, well, come over to my neck of the woods and let's go to Plank Road Pizza. And that's, I think that is really what is helping to make St. Louis such a fantastic place to live.
And that, and that building Plank Road Pizza was in was pretty desolate. It was looked abandoned. It looked pretty run down. I mean, they put quite a bit of money in there to make it look as sharp as it does. So there's somebody who's, not tearing down and building something new, but sort of taking care of the old and sort of rebuilding.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, and again, that's what we're seeing across the entire St. Louis area is people coming in and rehabbing these buildings and showing some love to our history,
right.
and launching these fantastic independent businesses.
All right.
Well.
Plank Road Pizza on Cottleville, right there on Highway N. Quickly, what's number two?
Number two, if you have pizza, you have to have beer. And so there is a new shop called Craft Beer Cellar in Clayton. It's at 8113 Maryland Avenue, and it's run by, I believe, their brothers. And it's essentially, I would call it a beer boutique.
Hmm.
They have 592 craft beers available for purchase from 179 different breweries.
Hold on a second.
Wow.
How many beers?
592 separate craft brews available.
I'm not
exaggerating.
So did you try each and every one of them?
You should have called me for that night.
I mean, this place, if you are a person who's interested in beer, like if you're a beer nerd, this is a place where you can go and completely nerd out. But if you're not that familiar with craft beer and you've heard about it and you're ready to kind of dip your toe into the water, the guys that run this shop, they pride themselves on being knowledgeable and open and available. And it's really meant to be a place where when you go in, you can pick their brains. Kind of the way that in a great wine shop, we've talked about a lot of the awesome wine shops, this is a great beer shop.
Right.
And, you go in and they actually allow you to do a mix and match, like six packs. So you can go in and pick anything that you want off the shelf and just mix and match everything, anything that you want to try. And they have events all the time. Actually, today's the 16th. No,
today's the 17th.
Never
mind. It was yesterday. They had a great event
yesterday. They had a great event yesterday. If you go to their website, you can find kind of their I don't know my head from my tail anymore. I was just kind of like running all over the place, so I apologize for getting a date wrong. But, they have a ton of different events, and if you just go to their website, which is craftbeercellar.com, I mean, the idea of, in the beverage industry, so much of it is just trying and just getting
right.
out there and meeting the brewers and meeting the people that are making these wonderful products. And so Craft Beer Cellar is terrific about having an ongoing event schedule, casual, where you go in. The one on the 16th was like the guys from second shift brewing, and these are fantastic brewers that are located here in St. Louis, and so you can go and try the beers, meet the brewers, and just fall deeper and deeper in love with local craft beer.
Two great ones today, Kat. You got Plank Road Pizza on Highway N in Cottleville. Don't forget to check out Menino's, too, while you're out there. Bring home some beef from the meat market over there.
Oh, hey, by the way,
yes.
You know what? I'm on their website right now, and it looks like they posted this on the 16th. It actually is this Friday, where you can go out and meet the guys from Second Shift Brewery.
Okay.
And taste their dry-hopped Katy, which is named for the Katy Trail. So.
All right, good. And that's Plank Road Pizza in Cottleville, and then Craft Beer Cellars, 8113 Maryland Avenue. Check out their 592 beers. If you drink them all in a half hour, you get a T-shirt.
Don't say that.
Kat Neville,
I don't know about that.
Quickly, Kat Neville, what's going on with Feast Magazine?
We are, so keep your eyes out next week we are launching the new regional issue, and it's going to be hitting streets next Friday and Saturday, and we're going to press right now. It is so exciting. I love this issue. It's going to be 100 pages.
Oh, boy.
So, yeah, I mean, we're going,
wow.
I mean,
wow.
I cannot wait to show this to you guys. I'm really excited about the entire Feast team has done an amazing job.
The first issue of Feast had how many pages?
I don't even remember.
18?
Quite frankly, I'd have to go back and look. That was maybe 4 years ago.
Wow. Yeah, 100 pages. Wow, that 100. Is great. And we've been there every step of the way.
That's
Kat,
right.
We are proud of you. We're thrilled. We'll see you next week. Get your mobility fixed, and then we'll see you next Wednesday.
Okay, I look forward to it.
All right. Kat Neville and Feast Magazine, FeastSTL.com, is sponsored by Bertarelli Cutlery, keeping St. Louis sharp since 1967. Bertarelli is your one-stop shop for knife and tool sharpening, along with all their kitchen supplies. Visit them at 1927.